A couple of days back, Apple announced that they're going to launch their new lineup of MacBooks, and YouTube went wild over making videos on it. Now, I've got my hands on the new MacBook Pro with the M1 chip, which is the base model for the new MacBook lineup. And this is a model which is starting at $1,999. I got this for about the same price plus some taxes. This is something which people might want to buy instead of the normal MacBook Pro, which was launched in 2020. Now, there is a price difference between the normal MacBook Pro and the 2021 MacBook Pro, the base model, but I believe that price difference is worth it for a few reasons. Now, before I unbox this thing for you, I'm going to talk about those reasons and discuss that with you. So one of the first reasons that I feel that the price difference is worth it is the display. Display has the mini LED technology, and the black and the contrast is amazing. The display is so nice that it stands out. In one of the YouTube videos, I saw that all lights were dim, wherein they were comparing a MacBook Pro 2020 versus a MacBook Pro 2021. And with all the lights dim, the black for the newer version of the MacBook Pro was amazing. It was pitch black, and the notch was completely hidden. You could not even notice that there's a notch on the new MacBook Pros. The second reason why you would want to choose the new edition of the MacBook Pro instead of the previous 2020 version is the addition of ports. The previous version, the 2020 version, had only two USB Type-C ports on them, but this one has three USB Type-C ports, one MagSafe charger, which is a dedicated charging slot for the laptop, one HDMI port, and an SD card port. So that is all the ports that you might need to do all your professional level work. So that is also something using which you can have lesser dongles and lesser accessories to carry along with this piece of device for your work. Now, the third reason why you should go ahead for the latest MacBook Pros instead of the previous generation is the life of these devices. A MacBook would last you anywhere between 5 to 8 years. My previous MacBook was a 2012 MacBook Air, which I sold earlier this year around January or February in 2021. Not because it became slow, only because I wanted to upgrade myself sometime down the road, sometime in the future, once the new MacBooks come out. And yes, I have been waiting for these devices. I was thinking of upgrading to the M1 chip based devices, but I said no. If the M1 chip is good, the next version of the M1 chip would be even better. And if I've waited so long, I should wait for the newer generations to come before I make that decision, because I feel Apple devices last long, and you should wait and invest in the right Apple device so that you can get the proper return on investment on these devices. Now, there are many other reasons why you should get the new MacBook Pro. The design, the black ionized keyboards, the full HD camera on the top, and many other things. This laptop is a beast. So without wasting much of your time, let's unbox this device and see how this thing opens up. Now, you might have seen multiple unboxing videos for the new MacBook Pro 14-inch. This, as I mentioned, this is the MacBook Pro 14-inch, the base model, which is having a 16 GB RAM and a 512 GB SSD. This is a unified chip setup, which is known as the M1 chip, and this is the Pro edition of the M1 chip. This does not have the M1 Max chip. If you want to boost it with the M1 Max chip, you can do that. You can boost the 14-inch version or the 16-inch version with the highest specs possible from the Apple lineup. This is the base model. And now let's unbox this device. So the unboxing starts from here. There's a tab, you pull it up, and you open it. Now, this is a dream that I have been seeing for quite a number of years before I could get my hands on this device. MacBooks are pretty expensive, and I have been saving up to make this dream come true for a couple of years now. And I know that Apple would launch something which would be worth buying. Again, my previous generation 2012 MacBook Air was amazing. I loved it. The speed, the productivity that I had arrived at with the previous generation MacBook Air 2012 version was amazing. The hand gestures, the trackpad and everything was really beautiful. So now let's open the box and see the device. So it's raising the box up like any other Apple product. And that's the MacBook Pro 14 inch. And let's pick it up. So that's the device in hand. Pretty heavy. It's not your lightweight or ultrabook laptops that you have. If you want an ultrabook laptop, get yourself a MacBook Air. That's amazing. The size of it is amazing. The slimness is amazing. But this is for getting work done through a device. Recently, if you follow MKBHD, you would have seen one of his videos regarding the MacBook Pros, the latest ones. And he rightly put it, this is a tool for you to get your work done. And it is that. That's all. Nothing less, nothing more. This is a tool for you to get your work done. And it was rightly put. Now, this is the USB Type-C to MagSafe chargers, which comes along with it. And under the slot here, you have the manuals. And you would have the stickers and things like that. It's here. I think there's something else hidden within this box. Maybe some more manuals. It looks like a padded casing just to make it more thicker. But doesn't seem like there's anything else within it. You have the Apple stickers over here and some manuals, which I'm not sure who reads them. That's good. Let's put it back where it belongs. And let's just see what else is there. You have another sheet of paper, which then comes out with a plug and a charger. So that's the charger. It's a USB type C charger. You need to put this in here, plug it up with your USB type C to MagSafe cable, and then plug it up into your MacBook, and your MacBook starts charging. That's how simple and easy it is for you to get started with your MacBooks. So that's the unboxing for the MacBook. I will wrap up this video over here. And I will see you in the next one, so that we keep these videos short and simple. Again, I would be making another video wherein I will be opening up this device and showing you the entire setup of the new MacBook Pro 14 inch. This looks like a brick, but a very beautiful one. So that's all for this video. If you would like to see more of the MacBook Pro M1 Pro chip, subscribe to this channel, hit the like button, hit the bell button so that you are alerted as soon as there's a new video launched on this channel. So thank you once again. I hope you enjoy this video. Put your comments down below to tell me if you would like to test this device in some way, or if you would like to see some videos on some other topics of the MacBook M1 Pro chip, the MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro chip. So that's all from me on this video. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.